Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Dr. Faiza Sheikh, junior resident of Department of Radiodiagnosis at MGM Medical College, Navi Mumbai. And the topic of my paper presentation is diagnostic value of screening mammography and subsequent ultrasound correlation of non-palpable breast lesions in asymptomatic women. The aims of my study are as follows. That is, if primary breast screening by mammography is capable of detecting suspicious lesions pertaining to breast cancer in asymptomatic women who are in the age group of 40 to 59 years with no increased risk of breast cancer, to assess these findings and give BI-RADS final assessment categories, which are going to be based on initial mammographic and subsequent sonographic evaluation, to make suitable decisions regarding interventions and follow-up based on these sonomammographic findings and to give final BI-RADS assessment categories. We all know that breast cancer is the leading cancer in women worldwide in both developed as well as developing countries and the fifth most common cause of death due to cancer in the general population. The annual incidence of breast cancer varies widely worldwide. Although the rates are higher in developed countries in recent years, breast cancer incidence has also increased in developing countries. Early detection of breast cancer comprises of two main strategies, that is screening and early diagnosis. Because the early detection of breast cancer before there is a palpable nodule increases the chances of survival, routine mammography screening and physical examination are recommended. In the age group of 40 to 49 years, breast cancer incidence is lower than that of patients who are in the age group of 50 to 59 years. However, the occurrence of dense breast and fast-growing tumors is higher. Breast cancers are biologically more aggressive in young women with more frequent adverse histopathological characteristics and worse prognosis than older women. The objective of this study is to assess the mammography findings in women who are in the age group of 40 to 59 years with no increased risk of breast cancer and to compare these findings with ultrasound and give final BI-RADS assessment categories in order to guide suitable interventions. So we had a total of 545 women who were in the age group of 40 to 59 years who underwent mammography screening between November 2020 and April 2021, which were included in our study. Women with breast-related complaints like pain, nipple discharge, or positive physical findings like shrinkage, bulging, nodules, hardening, were excluded along with those at high risk of breast cancer. Women with the following characteristics were considered to be at high risk of breast cancer, that is, who had an early age at onset of menarche, late age at onset of menopause, a first full-term pregnancy after the age of 30 years, family history of premenopausal breast cancer in first-degree relatives, and a personal history of breast cancer or benign proliferative breast disease. So for each patient, a detailed history was taken, which included all these factors: age at first childbearing, age at menarche, age at menopause, history of breastfeeding, number of children, history of hormonal therapy, history of premenopausal breast cancer amongst first degree relatives, personal history of breast cancer, benign proliferative breast disease, as well as radiation, chemical exposure, and smoking, if any. A detailed analysis was conducted, which comprised of mammography, ultrasound of breast, and histopathological examination wherever indicated. So we had conventional film screen mammography being performed with at least two views per breast, that is mediolateral oblique and craniocaudal. Additional views or spot compression views were obtained wherever appropriate. We had the breast density grading determined and reported according to the latest ACR BI-RADS categories. Ultrasound examinations were henceforth performed using a high-resolution unit, the linear array probe. All ultrasound examinations were performed with the patient in supine position for the medial parts of the breast and in the contralateral posterior oblique position with the arms raised for the lateral parts of the breast, and hence we scanned the whole breast. Sonographic and mammographic findings were then assessed and reported according to the latest ACR BI-RADS, that is breast imaging, reporting and data system categories. Then we categorized women in four categories, that is A, B, C, and D. We had 117 patients in category A, whose breasts were almost entirely fatty, we had 155 patients under category B, whose breast parenchyma had scattered areas of fibroglandular density, 135 patients under category C, whose breast parenchyma were heterogeneously dense, and 138 patients under category D, whose breast parenchyma were extremely dense. So these are the images of the patients who were included in our study. As you can see in the first image, that we have an almost entirely fatty breast parenchyma falling under ACR by that's category A. We had a breast parenchyma where we had scattered areas of fibroglandular density falling under ACR by that's category 2B. We had heterogeneously dense breast parenchyma falling under ACR by that's category C, and extremely dense breast parenchyma falling under ACR by that's category D. So these are some of the cases from amongst the total 545 women which were included in our study. Here we have a 56 years old female patient and whose mammography findings had both the breast displaying scattered areas of fibroglandular density, which limits mammographic evaluation, which came under ACR category B. No other mass lesion, microcalcification, asymmetric areas, or architectural distortion was seen. The skin subcutaneous tissue nipple areolar complex appeared normal with no significant axillary lymphadenopathy. This is the manner in which we reported our mammography findings. Then on ultrasound, we had a 1.4 centimeter sized, well-circumscribed, anechoic, oval, parallel mass with imperceptible walls, marked posterior acoustic enhancement, and with no evidence of internal and peripheral vascularity on color Doppler study. So our final impression was that of a simple breast cyst, and this came under ACR by that's category 2, of that is the benign category. This is how we reported our ultrasound findings. Next, we had a 42 years old female patient whose breast displayed extremely dense breast parenchyma, which limits mammographic evaluation, and this came under ACR category D. No other mass lesion, microcalcification, asymmetric areas, or architectural distortion was seen on mammography. Then on ultrasound, we had prominent fibroglandular architecture, which was noted bilaterally. However, no discernible mass was noted. No evidence of any calcification, nipple retraction, or skin thickening, and hence the final diagnosis was fibrocystic changes or fibroadenosis, and hence we gave a final category of 3 according to the ACR BILAT system. Then we had a 52 years old female patient whose breast displayed extremely dense breast parenchyma, which limited mammographic evaluation, and this we placed under ACR category B. On mammography, we also saw a large encapsulated mass in the upper quadrant, as can be seen by the other heads, containing both fat and glandular elements, giving a breast within a breast or the cut sausage appearance. No other features of microcalcification, asymmetric areas, or architectural distortion were seen, with the skin subcutaneous tissue and the nipple areolar complex also appear normal, and no significant axillary lymphadenopathy was seen. On ultrasound, a heteroclitic lesion presenting glandular and fat components with a thin echogenic pseudocapsule, which was suggestive of a fibroadenal lipoma. Pathology was then confirmed by an histopathological examination, and we gave the final diagnosis of fibroadenal lipoma or hamartoma, and this came under ACR by its category 2, that is benign category. So a total of 22 breast lesions out of 545 total asymptomatic subjects were examined, and psychological examination, the final aspiration, was indicated for patients with BILATS category 4 and 5. Final histological diagnosis was obtained, and all cases were verified by reviewing the histopathological report. And hence, histopathology results revealed the presence of a total of 19 invasive breast cancers and 526 benign lesions. So these are the results from our study, where we had a total of 545 asymptomatic women in the age group of 40 to 59 years, who were screened by mammography and subsequent ultrasound, which revealed the presence of 19 invasive breast cancers and 526 benign lesions. We had a total of 8 patients with invasive ductal, total of 7 patients with invasive lobular, 1 patient with mixed type of cancer, 1 patient with tubular, 1 under medullary, and 1 with mucinous carcinoma. So we see that we have maximum number of patients with invasive ductal type of breast carcinoma. This is a final BILATS assessment category scoring system, where we had 0 patients under category 0. We had a total of 210 patients under category 1 of negative, and hence a further management was routine mammography screening. We had a total of 297 patients with category 2 of benign findings, and this And the further management for this category was routine mammography screening. We had a total of 16 patients under category 3, that is probably benign. Then we had further management by short interval follow-up, that is 6 months, or continued surveillance mammography. We had a total of 3 patients under category 4A, that is having a low suspicion for malignancy. However, our further management was tissue diagnosis for these patients. We had 0 patients under category 4B and 4C, that is moderate suspicion for malignancy and high suspicion for malignancy respectively. We had a total of 19 patients under category 5, which was highly suggestive of malignancy, and hence further management comprised of tissue diagnosis. And we had 0 patients under category 6, that is known biopsy proven malignancy. So from our study, we find that screening mammography is therefore recommended every 1 to 2 years for women once they reach 40 years of age, and every year once they reach 50 years of age. Screening is usually cost effective and justified when the disease burden is relatively high and adequate health system capacity has been achieved, and when the quality of the entire multidisciplinary screening process is assured. In patients with dense breast tissue, we find that ultrasound is capable of raising sensitivity for the detection of breast cancer, especially for ACR BI-RADS categories C and D of dense breast parenchyma. In the case of a patient without any symptoms, breast ultrasound is the highest sensitivity for detecting breast cancer in women with dense breast tissue, women under the age of 50 years, and high-risk women. So, out of 545 asymptomatic women, our study had 177 with category A, 155 with category B, 135 with category C, and 138 with category D breast parenchyma as per the ACR BI-RADS category system. So we see that we have maximum number of patients with category A, that is almost entirely fatty breast parenchyma, and the least comes under category C, that is heterogeneously dense breast parenchyma. Our study also revealed a total of 19 BI-RADS 5 lesions, which were highly suggestive of malignancy, and 3 BI-RADS 4A lesions, which were suspicious for malignancy, with histopathological confirmation obtained amongst these asymptomatic women with no risk factors for breast cancer. A total of 297 BI-RADS 2 lesions of benign category and 60 BI-RADS 3 lesions of probably benign categories were discovered from our study. These are my references. I've taken reference from effectiveness of mammography screening in reducing breast cancer mortality in women aged 39 to 49 years, a meta-analysis. Also, ICT of mammographic screening in women from age 40, results of screening in the first 10 years by Moss, Thomas, Evans, and Thomas. Risk of radiation-induced breast cancer from mammography screening by Yap. And solid breast nodules, use of sonography to distinguish between benign and malignant lesions by Stavros, Stigman, Dab, Dennis. Thank you very much for this opportunity.